Long, long time ago, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Please join me in reciting the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
We were going to lower the casket now, if that is acceptable to people. And you'll have an opportunity to put a little earth upon the casket to say goodbye to the body of Pete, but not to Pete, because there's this thing that is everlasting, and that everlasting thing is love. And it not only resides in your heart, it resides in Pete's heart, because even though he's gone from us, he's still alive. We'll greet you when your time comes, because love never ends. Gentlemen. As the casket is lowered, let's be mindful that the body is the house in which you live, in which Pete lived. Pete is no longer there. His soul, his consciousness, is in and with God. And when the time comes, please take a moment to spread a little soil in remembrance.
On behalf of Pete's entire family, I take this opportunity to thank you all for joining in this graveside funeral service in celebration of his life this afternoon, for sharing your love and support with them throughout this most difficult time in their lives. Your presence here today speaks louder than words could ever, and we hope someday soon to be able to grieve like we have in the past, to hug and hold one another as we should during a time like this. As was said, the cemetery personnel will now bring over earth if you'd like to place some earth upon Pete's casket before turning to your cars. This does conclude our services. Thank you.
Still got one more thing, Al. I wanted to say one more thing. I guess today I'm the designated DJ for the music. This last song, it had to happen. This last song is dedicated to my nephew Pete, Peter Matthew. If there was ever a real life Andy and Opie Taylor relationship in the world, it was between your dad and you, Pete. Hopefully there are some people here that remember the Andy Griffith Show. You mentioned to me how you enjoyed listening to some of his favorite songs together as you'd ride with him in his new cars. Your dad and I long debated the meaning of one of those songs. I still haven't found what I'm looking for by you two. The song appears to be about spiritual fulfillment and the conflict between knowing that God exists and the desire for earthly things. It recognizes the mistakes we make, but it expresses a hopefulness in finding peace and surrendering all to God. As U2 sings the lyrics, I believe in the kingdom come that all the colors will bleed into one. And I'm sure Pete's experiencing that now. Let's give a listen.
I hear
Now may the peace that surpasses all understanding, that awaits us all with renewed life and love, bless your hearts and bind you together as one people in love forevermore. Thank you for coming. Amen.
Amen.